as I told you, now we will take up inverse hyperbolic functions concepts and some of the problems we will work out. Definition is one intake. Sin hx is equal to y implies that is x is equal to sin h inverse y. Sin h inverse y. Two, sin cos hx is equal to y, we will take implies x is equal to cos h inverse y. Three, tan hx is equal to y implies x is equal to tan h inverse y, and etc. The remaining are same, etc. Now we will find out. So that is x plus or minus square root of x square plus 1, but e power y is always positive. E power y is greater than 0 implies e power y is equal to x plus square root of x square plus 1. Otherwise, if you take minus sign, you get a negative number, but e power y is always positive. So therefore, y is equal to log of x plus square root of x square plus 1 to the base e itself. So that is sin h inverse x is equal to log of x plus square root of x square plus 1 to the base e. Similarly, we can, by taking the definition of hyperbolic functions and the functions, inverse hyperbolic functions, we can derive the other inverse hyperbolic functions. We can get cos h inverse x is equal to log of x minus plus square root of x square minus 1, and tan h inverse x is equal to half of log of 1 plus x by 1 minus x to the base e. Of course, here x should be x lies between minus 1 and plus 1. Of course, that will give you, and cos h inverse sin h inverse x is there. Tan cot h inverse x half of log of x plus 1 by x minus 1. Of course, here x must be greater than 1 or mod x greater than 1. This is for mod x greater than 1. And for this, I told you already, mod x less than 1. Okay. And secant h inverse x is log of 1 plus square root of 1 minus x square whole by x to the base e, of course, for mod x less than 1. For mod x less than 1, or mod x less than or equal to 1. Or I will write 0 less than x less than or equal to 1 itself. And cosecant inverse, H inverse X, this will be split into two parts. Cosecant H inverse X is equal to log of 1 minus square root of 1 plus X square by X if X is less than 0, and log of 1 plus square root of 1 plus x square by x if x is greater than 0. If x is greater than 0. So, you must take seriously when you calculate cosecant in H inverse x, you must see whether x is less than 0 or x is greater than 0. When x is less than 0, you have to use this form. This one value. When x is greater than 0, you have to use this one. Problem 1. Log of cot theta by 2 to the base e is equal to 1 sin h inverse cos theta, 2 cos h inverse sin theta, 3 tan h inverse cos theta, and 4 cot h inverse sin theta. Okay, right. The solution is cot theta is equal to cot theta by 2. This also. Cot theta by 2 is equal to half of log of e cot square theta by 2. Log e cot square theta by 2, log of cot theta by 2 to the base e is half of log, because this 2 comes outside. So, that we can write as half of, now use that logarithm value, that is half of log of 1 minus cot square theta, is not 1 plus cos theta by 1 minus cos theta. 1 plus 1 minus cos theta, or that is simply, you can have that is, so therefore tan h inverse cos theta is equal to 1 plus cos theta by, you can have that is, now by definition or by the formula tan h inverse x is equal to half of log of 1 plus x by 1 minus x. So, now take x is equal to cos theta. So, this is, so what you get is simply 1 plus log x is equal to, so therefore, tan h inverse x, h inverse of cot theta by 2 is equal to tan h inverse cos x. Tan h inverse cos x, or what is called cos theta. Option number 3 itself. See, once again I will explain you, log of cot theta by 2 to the base e is equal to half of log e of cot square theta by 2, because these 2 will come outside, 2 will cancel. That is half of cot square theta by 2 is 1 plus cos theta by 1 minus cos theta. Now this you can write as actually, this is actually, what is actually, if you take x to cos theta, half of log e, log of to the base e, 1 plus x by 1 minus x, this is. And but that is tan inverse x, means tan inverse, take x to cos theta. So therefore, tan log of cot theta by 2 is equal to tan h inverse of cos theta, x is equal to cos theta. So this is, in this, we are taking x is equal to cos theta. So then you will get this is equal to tan h inverse cos theta. So option 3, half log 1, half log 12 to the base e 2. Half log 3 to the base e. Next, 2 is half log 6 to the base e. 3, half log 12 to the base e. And 4 is log 3 to the base e. Right? Now we can have that is tan h inverse half plus cot h inverse 2 is equal to half of log 1 plus half by 1 minus half plus half of log of 1 plus 2 by 2 minus 1, by 2 minus 1. Simply by using tan h inverse x and cot h inverse x. In tan h inverse x definition, put x equal to half. In the cot h inverse x definition, put x is equal to 2. Okay, so that is half of log 3 by 2 by 2, 3 by 2 into 2, so log 3 plus log 3 to the base e. So that is simply log 3 to the base e. 2 log 3, so half, so log 3 to the base e. This is 3 sine h inverse of x by square root of 1 minus x square is equal to 1 cot h inverse x, 2 minus cotangent hyperbolic x, 3 minus tan h inverse x, and 4 is tan h inverse x. Tan h inverse x. Here also you simply use sin h inverse x definition. So sin h inverse x, we know that log of, what is the definition of sin h inverse x? I have written, that is simply log of x plus square root of x square plus 1, that is. So here replace x with x by root over 1 minus x square. Of course, automatically for this 1 square root of 1 mod x less than 1. So, replace x with the square root, x by square root of 1, so that sin h inverse x, x by root over 1 minus x square is equal to log of x by root over 1 minus x square plus square root of x square by x square by this one is not x square by 1 minus x square plus 1 plus 1. So that is log of x by root over 1 minus x square plus, if you simplify it, x square will cancel. So you will get, so 1 by root over 1 plus 1 minus x square. So that is simply log of 1 plus x by square root of 1 minus x square. And 1 minus x square you can write as 1 plus x into 1 minus x. So this is log of square root of 1 plus x by 1 minus x. So that is half log of 1 plus x by 1 minus x. And you know that is simply nothing but tan h inverse x. This is nothing but, by definition, that is, by the formula, that is nothing but tan h inverse x. So answer is 4. Answer is 4 itself. Problem number 4. If cos h inverse x is equal to log of 2 plus root 3 to the base e, then x is equal to 1, 2, 1, 3, 3, 4, 5 is a 5 itself. And you know that log of, by hypothesis, log e 2 plus root 3 is equal to, this is log of x plus square root of x square minus 1 to the base e. Okay, so this shows that, so 2 plus root 3 is equal to x plus square root of x square minus 1. Or you can write this as implies, simple, by observing, if you put x is equal to 2, then what you look at is 2 plus 4, square root of 4 minus 1, which is 3. That is, x is equal to 2, since 2 plus root 3, 2 plus root 3 is equal to 2 plus square root of 2 square minus 1. So, x is equal to 2. X is equal to 2. So, the answer is right. Now, again, another problem. E to the power of log of cos h inverse 2 to the base e is equal to 1 half log 2 minus root 3 2 log root 3 minus 2. This is absurd. You know, this asked MCET examination. That is absurd. Log of root 3 minus 2. And 3 log of 2 plus root 3. And 4 log of 2 plus root 5. All logarithms are base e. Of course, all the logarithms in hyperbolic functions, for all the logarithms, the base is always e. Right. Of course, this we can eliminate from the first list itself, because root 3 minus 2 is negative. So, for a negative number, logarithm is not defined. So, in the first instance, this will be eliminated. Now, you have to see out of the rest 3, which is correct answer. This is. Now, by hypothesis, the left hand side is equal to cos h inverse 2, because e power log x is equal to x. So because e power log x is always x itself. Since e to the power of log x to the base e is always x. So cos h inverse 2 is log of 2 plus square root of 2 square minus 1, which is log of 2 plus root 3. Log of 2 plus root 3. So answer is number 3. Answer is option number 3. 2 tan h inverse 1 by 2. 2 tan h inverse 1 by 2 is equal to 1, 0, 2 log 2 and 3 log 3 and 4 log 4 to the base e. Right. Now you know that tan h inverse x is equal to log of 1 plus x by half log 1 plus x by 1 minus x to the base e. Now put both sides, put x is equal to half. So therefore tan h inverse 1 by 2 is equal to half of log of 1 plus 1 by 2 by 1 minus 1 by 2. So which is half of log 3, which is half of log 3 to the base e. So therefore 2 tan h inverse half is equal to log 3 to the base e. Log 3 to the base e. So which is option number 3. Tan h inverse x. Tan h inverse x is equal to a into log of 1 plus x by 1 minus x to the base e implies a is equal to 1, 2, 3, half, and 4. And 4 is 1 by 4. And by definition, and not by definition, by the formula, you can write, by the formula, tan h inverse x is equal to half of log 1 plus x by 1 minus x to the base e. So that a is equal to 1 by 2. So answer is 3. Secant h inverse x, secant h inverse 1 by 2 is equal to, 1 by 2 minus cosecant h inverse 3 by 4 is equal to number 1, log of 2 minus root 3 by 3 to the base e, 2, log of 3 into 2 plus root 3, log of 1 plus root 3 by 3, and 4, log of 2 plus root 3 by 3 to the base e itself. Now secant h inverse x is equal to log of, we know that secant inverse x is log of 1 plus root over 1 minus x square by x. So put x is equal to half, so that sin h inverse half is equal to log of 1 plus root 3, half means 1 by 4, 2, 2 plus root 3, 1 by 2 will cancel to the base e. And cosecant h inverse, for cosecant h inverse x, we know that this is what you get is the formula is log of 1 plus root over 1 plus x square by x for x greater than 0. That's why I mentioned when you calculate cosecant h inverse x, you must be careful whether x is positive or negative. Right. So therefore, cosecant h inverse 3 by 4 is equal to log of 3 by 4 plus square root of 1 plus 9 by 16 whole by 3 by 4. So this you will get it is log of, so this is 4, 25, 4, 4 will cancel, 3 plus 5 by 3. 3 plus 5 by 3. So that is log 8 by 3. 1 plus is not 1 plus. So 4 plus 5. 4 plus 5 by 3. So this is log 3. That is log 3. When x greater than 0, this is the formula. So now put x is equal to 3 by 4. 1 plus square root of 1 plus 9 by 16 by 3 by 4. So 4, 4 will cancel. So what you get is 9 by 3, log of 9 by 3, which is log 3. So therefore, sin h inverse half minus cosecant h inverse 3 by 4 is equal to, what is sin h inverse of? Log of 2 plus root 3 to the base e minus cosecant h inverse to the minus log 3 to the base e. And you know that log a minus log b is log a by b. So that is log of 2 plus root 3 by 3 to the base e. So what is the option? There is option. Right, fourth. Option number 4. Answer is option number 4 itself. Tan h inverse half plus cot h inverse 2 is equal to 1 half log 3 to the base e, 2 1 by 2 log 6 to the base e, and 3 half log 12 to the base e, and 4 log 3 to the base e. Tan h inverse x is equal to half of log to the base e into 1 plus x by 1 minus x. Now x is equal to half implies tan h inverse 1 by 2 is equal to half of log of log 3. X is equal, put x is equal to half. So x is equal to half means 3 by 2 by half. So 1 by 2 will cancel. Now cot H inverse X is equal to Cartesian is equal to half of log x plus 1 by x minus 1. Implies now that is x is equal to, now you are given 2. X is equal to 2 means cot H inverse 2 is equal to half of again log 3. So minus. So therefore tan H inverse half plus cot H inverse 2 is equal to half log 3 to the base C plus half log 3 to the base C. So which is equal to log 3 to the base C, to the base E. So that means 4. See, unlike in trigonometric functions, in inverse circular functions, you know that tan inverse x plus cot inverse x is always pi by 2. Tan inverse x plus cot inverse x is always pi by 2. But here that is not the case. If cos hx is equal to 5 by 4, then cos h 3x is equal to 1 61 by 16 2 63 by 16 3 65 by 16 4 61 by 63. See, generally in object type questions, more than 50% of the questions, after out of the four options, one will be odd. If by seeing that one, we can guess that it's not an answer. It's not a correct answer. So you have to check it only from the remaining three only. In some questions, by inspecting the answers, we can easily reject two of the answers and check only out of the remaining two which is correct answer. That will be the case. Now cos H3x is equal to 3 cos HX plus 3 cos HX, the formula we are using. So the other way, 4 cos H cubed X minus 3 cos HX. So that is 4 into 5 by 4 whole cubed minus 3 into 5 by 4. So that is 125 by 16 minus 15 by 4. So that is 125 minus 60 by 16. So that is 65 by 16. So option 3. Right. 12. For 0 less than theta less than pi by 2, secant H inverse cos theta. Secant H inverse cos theta is equal to 1 log of, very big answers, log of mod tan pi by 6 plus theta by 2. 2 log of mod tan pi by 3 plus theta by 2, 3 log of mod tan of pi by 4 plus theta by 2. And fourth option is log of modulus of tan pi by 4 minus theta by 2 secant h inverse of cos theta is not. And you know that secant h inverse x is equal to log of 1 plus square root of, this is the standard formula, square root of what you get is 1 plus square root of 1 minus x square by x itself, by x for mod x less than or what you get is x less than 1 or 0 less than or equal to x less than or equal to 1. I have given you this formula equal to 1. Here x is equal to cos theta. X is equal to cos theta. So, x is equal to cos theta or not? Right. X is a cos theta. So, secant h inverse and x is equal to cos theta, and so that 0 less than cos theta less than 1. Because theta lies between 0 to pi by 2. Since 0 less than theta less than pi by 2. 0 less than pi by 2. So, sin h inverse cos theta is equal to log of 1 plus square root of 1 minus cos square theta by cos theta. So, that is log of square root of 1 plus sin theta by cos theta. So, that is log of 1 plus sin theta by square root of 1 minus sin square theta. Square root of 1 minus cos theta is square root of 1 minus sin square theta. So, that is log of square root of 1 plus sin theta by 1 minus sin theta. 1 plus sin theta by 1 minus sin theta. So, that is half log 1 plus sin theta by 1 minus sin theta. 1 plus sin theta by 1 minus sin theta. Now, this is, you know that tan h inverse x is 1 plus x by 1 minus x. So, this you can get it as, so half of log of 1 plus cos, cos pi by 2 minus theta by 1 minus cos pi by 2 minus equal to half of log of, so that is what you get is cos square pi by 2 pi by 4 minus theta by 2 by sin square pi by 4 minus theta by 2. So, that is half of cot square, log of cot square pi by 4 minus theta by 2. So, when you want to take the 2 outside, so 2 by 2 into log of, you have to write mod cot pi by 4 minus theta by 2. 2 will cancel. So the correct answer is, the third option must be, correct the third option. Log of, what is the third option? Log of mod tan pi by 4 plus theta. But what you got is, what is the answer again? Half of log pi by 4. Oh, it is correct. 2 will cancel. That is log of cot pi by 4 minus theta by 2 can be written as tan of pi by 2 minus of pi by 4 minus theta by 2. Because cot theta is equal to tan 90 minus theta. So this is log of mod modulus of tan pi by 4. Pi by 2 minus pi by 4 is pi by 4. Minus of minus is plus theta by 2. So option number 3. So what you did is correct. The only thing is, for the answer we got, we have to check whether it is, for which option it is equal. The option number 3, it is equal. This is actually, by simplification we will get, but this is, cot theta is always pi by 2 minus, tan pi by 2 minus theta. So you can write this is tan pi by 2 minus of pi by 4 minus theta by 2. So it is tan pi by 4 plus theta by 2. So which is option number 3? Now we know that cos H inverse x is equal to log of x plus square root of x square minus 1 to the base a. Now put x is equal to 1 so that cos H inverse 1 is log of 1 plus 0, which is log 1 to the base e, which is always 0. Log 1 to any base not equal to 1 is always 0. So option number 4. Option number 4 itself. Now 14. If, so this we did already. 14 is, if sin H inverse 2 plus sin H inverse 3 is equal to x, then cos HX is equal to 1 half of 3 root 5 plus 2 root 10, 2 half of 3 root 5 minus 2 root 10. And 3 half of 12 plus 2 root 50, 4 half of 12 minus 2 root 50. Right? You know that sin H inverse X is log of X plus square root of 1 plus X square. X plus square root of 1 plus X square. So, now put here X is equal to 2. Put X is equal to 2. And 3. So therefore, and adding, sin H inverse 2 plus cos H inverse 3, sin H inverse 3 is equal to log of log 2 plus square root of x square plus 1. Log of 2 plus root 5 plus x is equal to 3. So, 3 plus 3 means 3 square minus 1. This cos inverse x is not. Right. This plus log of 3 plus root 10 to the base e. X is equal to 3. X is equal to 3 means 3 plus root 10. Right. So that is equal to log of into 2 plus root 5 into 3 plus root 10. 3 plus root 10. That is. So therefore, now what he asked? Cos H inverse. Now you know that x is equal to, by hypothesis, x is equal to sin h inverse 2 plus sin h inverse 3, which is log of 2 plus root 5 into 3 plus root 10. 3 plus root 10. So e power x. So e power x is equal to 2 plus root 5 into 3 plus root 10, and e power minus x is equal to 1 by 2 plus root 5 into 3 plus root 10. So therefore cos hx, is equal to e power x plus e power minus x by 2. So that is 2 plus root 5 into 3 plus root 10 plus 1 by 2 plus root 5 into 3 plus root 10 by 2. So from this you will get to the correct answer. If you, after simplification, that simplification you can do it, and the correct answer is 3, option number 3. Now simplify it. So answer is option 3. Now secant H inverse of sine theta is equal to 1 log of tan theta by 2, 2 log of sin theta by 2, and 3 is log of cos theta by 2, and 4 log cot theta by 2. Right. Now, just you can recall that secant H inverse X, how much you can give? Just recall that definition, the formula which you have already given. Secant H inverse X is equal to log of 1 plus square root of 1 plus x square by x itself. For, of course, 0 less than x less than or equal to. Okay. Now here, put x is equal to sin theta. So therefore, secant h inverse sin theta is equal to log of 1 minus x square, log of 1 plus, that means sin theta, plus cos theta by sin theta. So which is equal to log of sin theta plus cos theta by x is equal to sin theta. So 1 plus cos theta by sin theta. So that is log of 1 plus cos theta is 2 cos square theta by 2 by 2 sin theta by 2 cos theta by 2. So which is equal to log of cot theta by 2 to the base e. So option is option number 4. 16 is 1 plus tan h x by 2 by 1 minus tan h x by 2 is equal to 1 e power minus x, 2 e power x, and 3 2 e power x by 2, and 4 2 e power minus x by 2. Right. So now you can take 1 plus tan h x by 2 by 1 minus tan h x by 2. Right. Is equal to 1 plus tan h by 2 is e power x by 2 minus e power minus x by 2 by e power x by 2 plus e power minus x by 2 whole by 1 minus e power x by 2 minus e power x minus x by 2 by e power x by 2 plus e power minus x by 2. Definition of tan h x. So if you complete it, if you simplify this, is these two will cancel. So 2 e power x by 2 by and 2 e power minus x by 2. 2 e power minus x by 2. 2 will cancel. So this is e power x by 2 whole square. So e power x. E power x. So the option is 2. Right? Sin h inverse x. Now you know that sin h inverse x is equal to log of x plus square root of x square plus 1. Is not? So this is given to be, so therefore log of x plus square root of x square plus 1 is equal to log of 5 plus square root of 26. So simply, obviously x is equal to 5, because when x is equal to 5, this is 5 plus 25 plus 1 root 26. Obviously x is equal to 5 is the answer. So 2, x is equal to 5. So today we completed hyperbolic and inverse hyperbolic functions with concepts and a good number of good problems. Of course, most of the problems are appeared in state MCET, combined state MCET, and separate state MCET and Telangana MCET also.